Today's subject is Maths of Standard 4th and name of the topic is Fractions. Dear children, this is part 1 of the topic Fractions. Now, let us learn here the meaning of the fractions, how to read them and how to write the fractions. Because this is very new chapter for you, isn't it? Okay, let us move to the topic. Please observe this. You know, this is a roti, isn't it? Or bhakri. In Marathi we call bhakri and in Hindi roti, isn't it? This is roti. And this is whole roti, full one. Isn't it? Akha roti, whole roti. Okay, now I will cut this in two equal parts. What I will do, because two children they are sitting to have the lunch, so I am going to divide this whole roti into two equal parts. Can you see here? Okay, I will take this away. Okay, two children, two half rotis, isn't it? This is a half roti of full, one whole, correct? And this is half part of that whole roti. Means, I have done two equal parts of one roti, isn't it? Two equal parts, remember this word. Two equal parts, then it becomes half roti of that whole roti. We got here two parts or two halves, isn't it? By one roti. Now, see this circle. Okay. Now, I will color this circle. See here. I have colored this circle by blue color, that is half part of this circle, and rest half I will color by red. Okay, means total how many parts? Here we have done two parts of a circle. These two parts are equal in shape and size, isn't it? That is nothing but half of full, right? Now here we can see an object, okay? Wood you can see, this is whole. Okay, again I will try to cut this and I will try to divide this in two equal parts. This is one whole, isn't it? Okay, see this, I am going to cut this in two equal parts. You can see here, two equal parts of this one whole. Right? Now I will take this away so that you can see properly. Yes, dear children, tell me how many total parts we made? Two. Right. And this one is half part of that whole, isn't it? And this is also a half part of that whole. Yes, dear children, see how we will write this half part. Here, one part we selected out of two parts. Total parts were two, isn't it? One is taken this side and one I kept here. See, this means this is half. How we write? 1 upon 2. Okay? Remember this means from two parts we have taken 1 or we have selected 1. Here you can see again a circular object. It is divided into two equal parts. One is colored in red and one is colored in black. Right? Now, here we have written the fraction, that is 1 upon 2, isn't it? Here it is line, you can see this line, the number above the line, that is 1, is called as numerator. What we call numerator means the number above the line. And one more number is there, that is below the line, that is called as denominator. Got this? Denominator means the number below the line. And dear children, this is nothing but fraction. What is this? Fraction. We always write fraction in numerator and denominator form. Yes, here numerator and denominator, both they are alike, isn't it? A little confusion is there. I will tell you one technique. Okay, this denominator is word has more letters compared to numerators, isn't it? So it is a little heavy and so it is below the line. Because it is heavy, so it is below the line. Like this you can remember. So denominator is nothing but the number below the line, and numerator, which is light, it has less alphabets compared to denominator, isn't it? So the number above the line is nothing but numerator. If you use this technique, it will become easy to remember. Got this? Now here again you can see here a circle. Now I will divide this in, we'll see how many parts we are going to divide this. See the different colors. Yes, we have divided this circle in 4 equal parts. The parts should be equal in fractions. Okay? Here we can see 4 equal parts and 4 different colors to each part. Isn't it? Each part has different color. Right? Here total parts how many? 4. Are they equal? Yes. All parts are equal. Now our roti. Okay, again we will divide this roti among 4 children. This you know, here we divided in 2 children, between 2 children. Okay, here total parts were 2, isn't it? The same roti we will divide in 4 equal parts. Can we see this? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Total parts are 4 here. Right? Got this, children? Here 2 parts, here 4 parts. This you know, this is called half. This is also half. Now we will learn the name for these total 4 parts. They are equal in shape and size, isn't it? We will learn. Okay, again we will take that whole object. Okay, this is a whole object. 1, isn't it? 1 piece this is. Now here also we will try to cut this in 4 equal parts. 2 parts, 3 and 4 parts. Correct? 4 equal parts we got here. Now what we will do? We will separate them. Okay, this is one part, this is second part, this is third and this is fourth part. Okay, means we have cut a one whole part into 4 equal parts. And dear children, this one part is called as quarter part. Remember the word quarter. In Hindi we say pav, right? Quarter part. This is also one more quarter part. This is also a quarter part of that whole. And this is also a quarter part. How we said there? Half part. Correct? Here 4 same size pieces are there, so they are quarter parts of that whole. And how we write this? Here total parts are 4, isn't it? So we write 1 upon 4, because one part, this is one part out of 4 parts, correct? So in the denominator we mention the total parts. What we will write here? Yes, same thing we will write here, because this is also one of the 4 parts. Here same thing. How we write quarter? 1 upon 4. See this? Got this? We use the word quarter when we divide one whole into 4 equal parts. Okay? And we use 1 upon 4. Here 1 is numerator and 4 is denominator. Okay? This is called quarter part. Now you can see here a cake. It is divided into 4 equal parts. The name of the one part is, you know, that is quarter part. That how we write? 1 upon 4. Or 1/4. We say 1/4. Yes, you know this part is nothing but 1/4. Correct? Now how many remained? How many parts remained? 1, 2 and 3. Got this? 3 upon 4 parts remained. So we used to write 3 upon 4. That is 3/4 for all together these 3. Okay, I will write here 1 upon 4. This is also 1 upon 4. Correct? You know this. This is also 1 upon 4th part. And this also 1 upon 4. Now, dear children, this is 1 upon 4. It is taken away. So, it is 1 upon 4. And these 3 portions, they remain here. So, 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. That is 3 times 1 upon 4. That is nothing but 3 upon 4. We will learn this in detail later, okay? How to read the fractions? You know, 1 upon 2, correct? This is nothing but 1/2. Means total parts are 2, and among these 2 total parts, 1 is selected. 1 is taken away. So 1 upon 2 or 1/2. How to read this? 1, numerator we say first 1, then upon 2. Okay, try to read this. Yes, you know the name. Okay, this is 1/4, means 1 upon 4, or we can say 1/4, or 1 upon 4, or 1/4, correct? 1/4. Next thing is 3 upon 4. Try to read this. Here 1/4, so it is 3/4. 3 parts are there, correct? So 3/4. Otherwise, we can say 3 upon 4. Or 3/4. This is 1/4. When we add 3 times 1 upon 4, we get 3 upon 4. That is 3/4. Or 3/4. Or 3 upon 4. Okay? Yes, children, here you can see an apple. Okay, I have taken a knife. Now I will cut this in 2 parts. So I will get like this. Isn't it? Means that is two half, correct? Or these are called as half parts. Individually they are half part of this apple, isn't it? Same apple, if I cut like this, then this piece is nothing but quarter part of this apple, 1/4, quarter part. In this apple, 4 people can eat like this part, isn't it? Okay, and what about these 3 parts together? Yes, you know the name, you know how to read, what to say. Yes, 3/4 part. This is 1/4, this is 3/4. Got this? Okay, good. Now here, divide the given figures into said portion. You can see here the figures. See, this figure, star, we have to cut it in half parts. This is a circle. We have to cut this in quarter parts. Here you can see a diamond. Cut it in a half parts. Means, half means, you know, we must cut this into 2 equal parts. Half, half, correct? Quarter means we need 4 equal parts. Again, half means here also we need 2 equal parts. Okay? Let us try to cut this or divide this star into half parts. Yes. Correct? We got 2 equal parts from one hole. That is nothing but half parts. Correct? 2 different parts we got here. About the circle, see, one horizontal cutting and one vertical cutting, it gives us 4 equal parts. Each part is called as quarter part, and here we have 4 quarters, correct? Now we'll move to diamond shape. Here also we have to divide this diamond into 2 halves. Okay, here also we will cut like this. Yes, here also we got 2 equal parts. That is nothing but half of this diamond and half of this diamond. Got this? Half parts. Good. Now, here one more thing is there. Please observe carefully. Okay, how many parts are there? This is a rectangle, correct? How many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we will write here total parts, that is 6. Now, some parts I will color. Okay. And we will count the colored parts. One part is colored. Second part is also colored. Third part is colored. Yes. How many parts are colored here? 3 parts. Okay. Here one more figure is there. One more rectangle. We will divide this rectangle into how many equal parts? And how many parts are colored? We will see. See total parts. That is 4. Isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4. And colored parts. Yes, tell me. Yeah, correct. 1. Okay, we will move to one more figure. Yes. How many total parts are there? And how many colored? We will see. You know the answer, isn't it? Total parts 3 and colored parts, yes, I can't hear. Yes, you are right, that is 2. Very good. Now, dear children, we will write these in fractional form. Okay? Colored parts. How many parts are colored? We will see in each figure. In the first figure, what we will write in the numerator and denominator? See, three colored parts out of six parts. So, total parts we write down. That is six parts are there, correct? So, we have written six in denominator. And how many colored part? Three. So, we have written three in the numerator. Now, come on, tell me about this figure. Yes, what to write? Yes, very good. 1 upon 4. Because 4 total parts it has and 1 is colored. And here, yes, very good. 2 upon 3. I hope you understand and you know how to write these fractions. Correct? Okay, we will go through some more examples. See this. There are three figures and some parts are colored. The figures are same, but the colored part, they are different in three different figures. Correct? In first figure, how we will write the colored part in fractional form? Yes. We will write, yeah, 1 upon 4 because 4 parts are there and 1 part is colored. Here in the second figure, yes, 4 parts are there, 2 are colored. Or one more thing, you know this. This figure has divided into 2 and 1 part is colored, second part is not colored, that also we can say. Here we can write 1 upon 2 also or 2 upon 4 also. The meaning is same. Here, how many parts are colored? 3 parts are colored out of 4 parts. So it is 3 upon 4. Right? Okay, yummy pizza. Now, here also we can learn about the fraction. Yes, dear children, tell me. I am taking away one part from this pizza. The pizza is divided equally into some parts. How many parts can you see here? Yes, very good. 8 parts. Nice. And one part I am going to take away. I am hungry and I want to eat. So, one part I am chosen. Right? So, here 1 upon 8 I have taken. And 7 upon 8 remained here. Remember this thing. Total 8 parts are there. 1 I will take away. How many remain? 7. But here what we will write? I have taken away 1. So, 1 upon 8 is the fraction. Now, 1 is numerator and 8 is nothing but denominator. Got this? Okay. Yes. You are also there along with me. Am I right? Myself, I have taken one piece and you are taking one piece. So, how to write fraction here? Yes. Very good. Denominator is 8 here because again 8 pieces are there. And myself one and yourself one means 2 pieces we are going to take away, isn't it? Very good. This is 2 upon 8. 2 is numerator and 8 is denominator. Got this? And how many pieces remained here? 6. Nice. Means 6 upon 8 remained. Isn't it? Yes, dear children, here you can see two figures. This is six-sided figure, that is called hexagon, and this is rectangle. Okay, observe carefully. We will cut this figure in some parts and we will color. And we will try to write the colored part in fractional form. Okay, see this. We are going to divide this figure. Yes. How many equal parts we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Isn't it? We have divided this hexagon into 6 equal parts. Some parts we will color. Yes. Now, how we will write this in fractional form? Can you tell me? Okay, tell me now. What we will write in numerator and what to write in the denominator? Very good. Denominator we will write 6 because 6 total parts are there. And how many colored parts are there? That we will write up. That is nothing but 1. One part is colored. Got this? Okay, let us move to the second figure, that is rectangle. Here also we will cut this figure in some parts. See here, now we got 2 equal parts. See this? Please count the parts. You go on counting the part. I will color some parts of this figure. Yes. Now come on, tell me what to write in numerator and what to write in the denominator. I am not going to help you now because you know how to write and what to write. Isn't it? Over. Okay, now I will write. You check the answer with my answer. 3 upon 16. 16 parts we got in this figure, and out of 16 parts, 3 parts are colored. Right? Very good. See this? Come on, tell me. First one, how to write the colored parts in fractional form? Yes, very good. 1 upon 2, correct? Because one part is colored out of 2 equal parts. In the second figure, we can see 4 equal figures. 1, 2, 3, 4. And how many parts are colored? 1. So, 1 upon 4. Here, this is familiar figure. The answer is 1 upon 4. Isn't it? Very good. Come on. Come on, write the answer. This is 1 whole. Isn't it? And this? Yeah. 1 by 2, very good. 1 upon 2 or 1 by 2. This colored part is 1 out of 4 parts, that is nothing but 1 fourth or 1 quarter or 1 upon 4. Here, colored parts 3 out of 4. So, 3 upon 4 or 3/4 or 3/4. Got this? Okay. What fraction does the colored part show? See this. This is for homework. You have to write the colored parts in the fractional form. I am not going to write the answers here. You write the answers and check with your friends or ask your mummy or any sister, brother or teacher. Okay? I think you are expert in writing the fractions. How many parts are colored and how many total parts, you know here. You can write the proper numerator and proper denominator. Right? Try this. Now, dear children, here one more thing we will learn. This is 1 upon 5. Means, in one object, 5 equal parts are there. Among them, 1 is selected. Correct? 1 upon 5 plus 3 upon 5. Means here, the same object, we have selected 3 parts. Then together, how many parts it became? Yes, 1 plus 3. That is nothing but 4 upon 5. Isn't it? Means in one object, we have divided that object into 5 equal parts and we have taken, first we have taken one part, then afterwards 3 part. So 1 plus 3 is nothing but 4. Means we have taken away now 4 upon 5 parts of that object. Yes, dear children, the condition is the denominator should be same here. Okay, remember, see here also 5, 5, 5, 5. One more example we will go through. 2 upon 9 means out of 9 equal parts, we have selected 2 parts. Plus 5 upon 9. See again, from 9 equal parts, we have selected 5 parts. That is equal to, come on, tell me. 5 plus 2. Is 7, isn't it? That is 7 equal parts out of 9 equal parts. Here also you can see the denominator is same. Right? Okay, one more. 1 upon 7 plus 4 upon 7 is equal to how much? Come on, tell me. 1 plus 4 is 5, isn't it? So 5 upon 7. Here also the denominator is same, right? Now 2 upon 11 plus 7 upon 11. How much? 2 plus 7 is equal to 9, isn't it? So, the answer is 9 upon 11. What is same here? Denominator is same. See this? 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. You know this is 1 quarter, this is 2nd quarter, this is 3rd quarter. Total how many quarters? You know the answer. That is nothing but 3 upon 4. 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is 3. And 4. Out of 4 parts, we have selected 3 parts. First time we selected 1 quarter. Then 1 more quarter we selected. After that, 1 more quarter. Correct? So together, we ate 3 parts of apple or 3 quarters. Got this? 1 upon 5 plus 1 upon 5 plus 2 upon 5. How much? Come on, tell me now. 1 plus 1 plus 2, that is 4 upon 5. Very good. Nice. I hope you understood about the meaning, reading and writing of the fractions. Isn't it? Dear children, in the next part, we will learn about some more new things about the fractions. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.